Again, Arjuna asks, "Oh Krishna, first of all, you ask me to renounce work, and then again you recommend work with devotion. Now, will you kindly tell me definitely which of the two is more beneficial? You will never be able to solve a problem if you start thinking which will be more beneficial. Please be very clear. You can never solve a problem if you start thinking which will be more beneficial. Before thinking which will be more beneficial, you should be clear of one point, with what scale you want to measure your benefits. That's the basic thing. What is the scale you are going to use to measure whether you are benefited or not? Whether you are successful or not? Before thinking whether you are successful or not, before coming to the conclusion whether you are successful or not, you need to know with which scale you are going to measure your life. Before that, unless you know the scale with which you are going to measure your life, you can't jump to conclusion. Jumping to the conclusion should be done with clear intelligence. Small one-liner. What do you call falling out of an airplane without parachute? That is jumping to the conclusion. Jumping to a conclusion. If you do it without a proper scale, you are just jumping to a conclusion. You don't know where you are landing. Before understanding, before measuring your life, whether you are successful or not, you should be clear with what scale you are going to measure your life. In the end of the day, if you are going to measure your life with the scale of dollars, then you have to work only for dollars. In the end of the day, you know with which scale you are going to measure your life. So from morning to evening, you will work only for that goal. End of the day, you know, yes, this is the scale with which I am going to measure my life. You can come to a conclusion whether you are successful or failure. But by the time you reach the evening, the very scale changes. Then what to do? In our life, when we start our life, the scale is different. When we end our life, the scale with which we are measuring whether we are successful or failure, the very scale changes. I can tell one thing, fortunately the scale changes. Only for a mature person scale changes. If you learn the lessons from existence, if you learn the lesson from life, the scale with which you will measure your life, whether you are successful or not, should change. If it does not change, please be very clear, you are going to take one more life from zero. Where you left, you are going to start your life from the same point. Unless you learn the lesson, you are not going to end the game. You are going to play the same game again and again and again. If the scale changes, the scale with which you measure whether you are successful or not, if it changes, it shows you are getting mature. If it stays with the same scale, dollar, if it stays in the, same scale, money, please be very clear. Not only you will not be able to measure your life clearly, second thing, you will be sure failure. Third thing, you will again start your whole game from day one. From day one, it's a very important thing. If only dollar is your scale, if only outer world comfort is your scale, be very clear, again and again you will feel you could have done little more. You could have done little more. I could have done little more. I think I missed. First, we need to understand with what scale you are going to measure your life, whether your life is beneficial or not. That itself must be defined. Only then you can enter, you can choose the path. The end of the day, end of your life, at the end of your life, how you are going to measure your life, that whether it was successful or not. Now itself, let you be very clear. What is the scale? Here Arjuna asks, Sanyasam Karmanam Krishna Punar Yoganja Samsasi Yasreya Yedayo Regam Danme Bruhi Sunishchitam. Now will you kindly tell me definitely which of the two, karma or sannyasa, which of the two is more beneficial? We are all again and again asking this question to ourselves. Man is dilemma. Please be very clear. Your mind is nothing but dilemma. Your mind will be alive as long as you are caught between the extremes. The moment you come to any single conclusion, you will be liberated. The moment you reach any conclusion, you will be liberated. You will be ignorant as long as you are moving from this extreme to that extreme. Don't say ignorance is bliss. If ignorance is bliss, why so many people are suffering in the planet Earth? Why do you think so many are suffering? Ignorance is not bliss. Innocence is bliss. That is different. Innocence means you will not carry a scale with which continuously you will be measuring your life. Ignorance means you will have a scale, but you are not able to fulfill your life according to your scale. If you neither have scale nor have a goal, then no problem. But here, you have intelligence, you have intellect, you have enough of intellect to have a scale, but you are not able to fulfill it. That is what I call ignorance. First thing we need to understand is man as such is a disease. The first and last disease is dilemma. Dilemma is the disease with which he starts his life and ends his life. I can't even say ends. He will be in a dilemma whether to end or not. It is just taken away from him. It is just taken away from him. Why do you think worry kills more people than work? Because more people worry than work. Worry is nothing but dilemma. Here, Arjuna is having a dilemma. Which is more beneficial for me? If you look into the whole life as a utility, some way of benefit, please be very clear, you are creating, you are building your own hell. Life has no separate benefit. Life itself is benefit.